Ever since the president caught corona, nothing feels safe. What's up, everybody? Ty Rivera here, the absolute best LGBTQ comedian in the world. Before we get started, please make sure you give it the thumbs up, comment when I get on your nerves, and subscribe so you know the next time that I'll be getting on your nerves. So, all day on Facebook today, people were making themselves look like horrible people, which I knew they would do because people are s***. I don't care what side of the aisle you're on, you're s***. And of course, there's the people that think that Donald Trump catching corona is a hoax, like he's pulling a hoax. And he may very well be, but the thing is, he's got you s***ed either way because you look like a horrible person if you say you hope he dies, and all your friends hate you if you say that you're at all sympathetic to him. So either way, you're screwed and Donald Trump is winning, because just like it was predicted in a tweet that I saw today that actually was from September, but the person was just giving a prediction and he basically predicted that this would happen to Donald Trump. And he also said that he's gonna dominate the news cycle for 14 days, and that's what's gonna happen. There's gonna be a 24/7, what's going on with Donald Trump, what's going on with his health. He just got flown to a hospital. He had to be taken by a helicopter, I believe it was. And I'm sure he's really hamming it up in there. And then when he comes through, he's gonna be the hero, ta-da! And he's really gonna ham it up then too. He's gonna sell a bunch of hydroxychloroquine because really he's been trying to push it already. And if you're smart, you pay attention to that and you're not like, oh, you're just coming up with a conspiracy right now. Whatever, shut up. In typical Democrat fashion, Joe Biden has said that he's going to take the ads off that say negative things about Donald Trump, which is such a dumb thing to do, and why I can't vote Democrat. Because they don't have killer instinct when it matters. They need to kill him. But they're not going to do that. Instead, what they're going to do is pretend to take the high road, which nobody in real life is taking the high road. And I don't mean that, you at home. Some of you saps, I'm sure, are taking the high road all the time, and I applaud you for it. But when it comes to our politicians, they are not taking the high road at all. They're just trying to look like they're taking the high road because it's better optics. But when it comes to Democrats, what we already know is you don't really care. Because if you couldn't play fair with Bernie Sanders, who's on your own side, then I definitely don't expect you to play fair or be nice when it comes to Donald Trump, who's the polar opposite of what you guys are going for right now. So, if you ask me, this is all just a plot to make it look like they have clean hands when really they don't. And since Donald Trump's not going to die anyway, because I'm telling you guys, Donald Trump is not going to die. There's the people that are really excited thinking he's going to die. You're stupid. He's not going to die. Even if you hate him, he is the president of the United States. He's getting the best care, and I'm sure he's going to be fine. Of course he's going to be clammy for a couple days. Whatever. It's what happens. We all get fevers. We know how it works out. But like I said, I can't ever vote Democrat because they're just bad with strategy. Like, if you ask me, there are so many ways that the American public could have already gotten Donald Trump to do what it is they want. He's a person that thrives on attention and popularity. Those are the two things that really drive Donald Trump. Attention and popularity. That's what he likes. That's why he always talks about the ratings on either what he's been doing or football or basketball. He always brings up ratings because to him, that equates to success. Popularity equates to success. So when you're dealing with a person that loves being popular and wants attention, and you'll give him attention more for doing bad things than you will for doing good things, because he has done some good things, but nobody ever brings that up because to them it doesn't feel good to give him any kind of credit. So the way he sees it is, okay, I better not do anything like that again because it doesn't get me attention. But if I do this bad thing, or if I say this particular thing about these particular people, then they lose it and suddenly I'm on the news for the next 2 days because people can't get over what I said 2 days ago. Well, instead of just ignoring him when he's doing things you don't like and paying attention to him when he's doing things that you do, you continue to give him attention for doing things that you don't like, which, like they say, negative attention is better than no attention for some people, and he happens to be one of those people. You really could have him eating out of the palm of your hand right now. You just stroke him a little bit, tell him, oh, Donald, I can't believe how big your dick is, whatever you have to say, and you get him to do what you want. Like Kim Kardashian seems to have a real knack for this. She got that lady Alice Marie Johnson out of prison, and then he fully pardoned her. So, I'm sure Alice Marie Johnson is a happy camper, but nobody bothered to give him any credit when he let Alice Marie Johnson free. And really, they should have still given him credit because hopefully he continues to do things like that. They're working on prison reform. Alice Marie Johnson has stayed in contact with Jared Kushner because he's the one that was heading that up. So all you have to do is give him attention when he's doing good things. Let him know that you appreciate it. By now, you really could have him eating out of the palm of your hands by just giving him some popularity and some attention for positive things. But nobody wants to do that. So instead, people just complain all the time. And then I feel like, well, I can't really take you seriously, because if it's as easy as humoring this person to get what it is you say that's so important to the American public, and you refuse to humor him, then is it really that important to the American public? Because to me, if I thought something was the most important thing in the world, I would definitely make sure that I did those things, because it's the most important thing in the world. How could I not do them? It's my responsibility to do these things, because all I have to do is do this and then everybody gets what they want. But instead you want to focus on, oh, I hate him so much and he's got little hands and he's orange. And it's like, yeah, okay, well then continue to push that and see if that gets you any closer to your goal. Because everything you say you want could be completely possible if you would just figure that part out. But you refuse to do it, and so I refuse to be on your side. Anyway, this has been Ty Rivera, the absolute best LGBTQ comedian in the world!